Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the 10th video of the TillyWiki development environment how-to. With the last video we did create a new file which is called ASTF in a new feature branch. I just want to have a short look at the directory structure. So there we can see there is ASTF.txt. If I switch the branches, then it checks out master branch and it removes ASTF.txt. So that's important, and it also says nothing to commit, working directory clean, which means that our file system exactly looks like the content of the master branch. If I say, if I switch to a new feature again, it will create ASTF.txt, which is here now, and it also says nothing to commit, working directory is clean. So it tells us that everything is in the same or is in good shape. So we don't need this ASTF.txt, so that's why we remove it. If we want to create a new feature, the first thing we always have to do is just check if Jeremy pushed something to upstream. So we switch to upstream and we pull, we say git pull. Then it connects to upstream directory and checks if everything is in good shape. Why not? Upstream. Pull from another branch, from master. Okay. Okay, maybe it knows already that everything is okay, so it doesn't even try. Okay. But that's the way how to do it. Now, how can we get rid of this branch? Because we already pushed it. It is there, but we don't really want to create the pull request. On our local repository, it's easy. We just click the X button here. And then it asks us if we really want to delete it. And we say yes. Okay, it is deleted now. In the web, because we pushed it already, so we have 5 branches, and one is our new feature XYZ branch, and here we have the possibility to delete this branch, because we don't really want to do something with it. Okay, so we delete it and it is gone. There would be a possibility to restore it, but anyway, we just don't need it anymore. Okay, so then I told you we want to create a new edition. For example, let's build the empty. Where is it? Empty. Here, the empty edition. So the important part here is that every edition in TillyWiki needs a TillyWiki.info file, which gives us some information about how it looks like, which themes are included, which plugins are included. In this case, no plugins are included. Then there is some build instruction, which is called build index. And so you can have many of them. So there is a build command, which says minus minus build index, and then it will execute this command. Otherwise, we would have to type every single parameter again. And because most of the time they don't change, it's possible to create, let's say, a build alias. So this one builds the index file, this one builds external images, so it extracts the images, and this one builds a static version of empty.html. So the easiest way to get going is to open the command line. In this case, we need to have the command line, and then we say node.js, TillyWiki.js. I just typed tid and then say tab, so it automatically uses the TillyWiki.js file. Then we go to editions, empty, and minus minus build index. So that's the command. Node.js. Command not found. Node. Ah, okay, it's Node. Yeah. And as you can see, it automatically created an output directory. Yeah. So that's the default setting. If we specify a different position, it always uses the subdirectory of the edition itself. So go to editions, empty output, and here is the file. If I say double click, I want to open it with Firefox. And now we have an empty edition built from scratch. Yeah. Okay, yeah, my server is active, so it wants to save it to the downloads directory. Okay. What else can we do? We want to build tdwiki5.com. It's this one. Yeah, so the same content as on the main homepage. So let's have a look. There is tdwiki info. There is a lot more of stuff going on. So there are several plugins which are part of this edition. Then there are basically all the themes. Then there is a build index, build empty, and so on. So different, several different possibilities. We want to build tdwiki5.com build index. Need some time, and as you can see, it created a new output directory. Editions tdwiki5.com output and index, big one. Okay, here it is. Yeah. So now we did build tdwiki5 homepage from scratch. Yeah, that's basically it. Yeah, so it's, let's say, that simple. Yeah. Once you have configured everything and set up the stuff, building tdwiki is just clicking this button to open the command line and then remember some commands, which are always the same. So first node, then tdwiki.js, then always the editions, the edition name, then minus minus build, and then you need to know the build alias. Yeah, that's basically it for this video. In the next video, we will have a closer look how we can include a feature branch from a third-party repository. For example, Tobias Bear has a very interesting pull request, or interesting branch, which is a pull request, and we want to test it on our system. Yeah, so this will be in the next video. Have fun!